Finally, a fix for a problem decades in the making. The city plans to begin paying to replace old lead pipes connecting the water to some people's homes and installing meters on those old lines to measure usage. CBS's Jeremy Ross is live in Beverly. Jeremy, this comes as a relief for some owners, but others who've been overcharged for water are asking, where's their relief?
And Brad, many of the homes in this community, 90 years old, 100 years old, and of course, the infrastructure is as well. So today's announcement certainly drawing attention here. The question is, how much is this going to help? And also, when will this help at this point?
Old structure, you know, so nothing had been updated.
Kathy Zook knows the way her home gets water needs to change. The old lead service lines connecting city water to the sink need replacing, and she needs a more dependable way to measure how much water she uses with a meter. Some older homes like hers don't have that. We have previously spoken with her and several others in our investigative series, Getting Hosed. Over the past 6 years, she has seen her wallet spring an exponential leak as a result of what she describes as wishy-washy water accounting.
The water bill initially doubled in price. My overcharge is probably to the tune of $8,000 over the years.
I'm not familiar with any overcharges.
She has good intentions on making things right. She pretty much inherited this problem.
But it's way past time for us as a city to address this issue.
Mayor Lori Lightfoot announcing a volunteer program aimed at approximately 380,000 lead service lines throughout Chicago's homes. The total cost to replace in the billions, with city leaders beginning with $15 million in block grants earmarked. Chicago is slated to provide complete replacement and water meters for some low-income households. For homeowners like Zook, the city will offer to waive permit fees for the removal and install a meter, a savings of up to about $3,000. But the homeowner will need to hire a contractor for the removal, and that can cost thousands of dollars on top of what Zook is spending on what she describes as wayward water bills per month.
I'm paying five times what some of the neighbors are paying.
Water department has plenty of resources to address those issues with.
I have reached out. I started reaching out at the end of 2019.
The mayor adding she will seek state as well as federal funding in this process, but no timeline given on exactly how long this could take. These plans do need city council approval. Assuming that does happen, the application process can begin later this fall. Live in Beverly, Jeremy Ross, CBS 2 News.